Please welcome Thomas and his gigantic testicle.
When I was 26 years old, I was diagnosed with stage 3 testicular cancer.
I'll give you a one guess as to what type of cancer we're talking about.
I'm a filmmaker, and I go, oh, okay, the only way I can deal with, like, really realizing, okay, I have cancer, is just started filming everything.
Thomas Alexander Campus.
I was diagnosed, they actually told me that I had cancer for at least 2 years.
Right now, I'm fairly bloated.
So my tongue hasn't had enough liquids. So I'm gonna rub it around with this thing.
The thing is, in society, we've created this, like, block that we have to be like men and we can't show weakness. I wanna break down that barrier and be like, you know what, it's okay. I never had the opportunity to really deal with the fact that I had cancer, so I like engaged with people and created this whole organization that I've been doing this movement. Now this year, it just started to hit me.
So your friend had cancer, and what type of cancer?
Lymphoma.
Lymphoma.
She's had it 3 times.
3 times, and how old is she?
She is 9.
9.
I'm gonna get a giant ball, and I'm gonna have people write all their stories on it, but I'm gonna travel across the country all in kind.
Sir, do you have your plug?
We don't know who we're going to interact with. I mean, we met the CEO of WitchWitch. He jumped on board. One of our other partners, Server Hub, he donated us the van. Like, if we had everything perfectly manicured all the way through, we wouldn't have had these amazing interactions with these people.
I think it's a wonderful thing to bring awareness to something.
It's all about awareness for young guys, just listening to their body, being proactive.
When you're treating a testis cancer patient, you're looking at a 95 to 99% cure for the majority of guys.
Are you 27-year survivor? Do you have the scar like us? Oh, we have that one too. We have it too, see?
When were you diagnosed?
July 8th this year.
My kind of struggle was all psychological.
I've had a lot of people go, you don't look like a cancer survivor. And I'm like, what does a cancer survivor supposed to look like?
How do we deal with the secondary effects of these treatments? That's, I think, our next big hurdle. We've got really good at curing them. Now, how do we treat the other things?
Future survivor, future like that. Survivor. Love it. Well, you know what? Yeah. You don't have to answer this if not, but so since you lost both, did you end up getting prosthetics?
Yes.
Yeah. Have you met any other testicular cancer survivors?
Nope, you guys are it.
Really?
Oh my god.
Day 2.
You mean day 48?
Thomas,
I hate saying this. The reason why I've just been so uptight and why I've been just so angry and frustrated.
He said he was very sorry, but he couldn't continue on this journey anymore, and that after we were going to talk, he was going to drive to San Francisco and head home.
I'm bad, bud. I love you too. I'm so sorry. Now I
sleep. He got a foxtail in his ear?
Nothing's in our favor right now, and it's just so frustrating. I knew it was steeped in blackened
hopes. I don't have the tips for a ball. I have a tip for a car.
Water means rebirth. It means a new beginning, right?
Yeah.
Kind of like first time on this journey and trip right now, I just feel like zen, like just completely relaxed and that everything's gonna be all right.
It's a testicular cancer awareness campaign. We're going across America.
Feeling guys' balls or what?
No, we're just telling them to check them.
It's amazing how receptive it is.
It's awesome.
Literally, you bring a giant ball with you on the street, people will talk about their nuts on the street.
Make sure you go get yourself checked too, hey? Once a year. Once a year. And I was still, but I was under your spell when I was told by. We yet again have no idea where we're staying.
sound like Count Dracula.
Literally, was I not kidding?
Like, this journey is a personal documentary, as well as, you know, engaging with all these people, but it's me that I've realized that I'm going, okay, now this is when I'm starting to deal with it.
For some crazy reason, I think we're gonna do it.